Today, let's take a look at Hollow Knight's heads-up display, how it might have been implemented, and how you can achieve a similar effect for your own projects. This won't be an exact step-by-step tutorial, but more of a conceptual look for people who already have a basic understanding of how to use the game engine of choice. I will be using Godot, but trying to keep things open enough you'll be able to apply the same things to other engines as well. But before we get started on building a UI of our own, how does Hollow Knight actually scale its UI? If you've worked with HTML, Godot's control nodes, or really any number of other GUI systems, you will be familiar with how much effort can go into making sure your user interface scales correctly at different screen sizes. Now, as I'm setting the game to window mode and moving it around a little though, it seems like Team Cherry chose the simplest option for UI scaling. They don't. The entire game, including the heads-up display, is drawn to a 1920 by 1080 canvas, and then the canvas is scaled to fit within the bounds of your window. To maintain its aspect ratio and not look stretched, the game just fills its remaining space with black borders. If, like me, you're using Godot, you can enable this type of scaling in the project settings. Just set your viewport width and height to whatever base size you want to use, and aspect to keep. If you're using any other engine, have a look around and most likely you'll find a similar option as well. Alright, so now that we know we won't have to worry about UI scaling, let's throw together the heads-up display. With a canvas layer as our base to make things stay in place at the top left of our screen, we can toss in some sprites for our various elements. We've got this wavy design thingy, a background for when the soul meter isn't full, some eyes, this white circle for the soul meter that fades at the edges, a geo icon, and of course, a mask to represent the player's health. I also added a parent node, just to group things together, as well as some debug buttons that will let me control all of this later. Next, waves. If you're anything like me, your first thought seeing the waves in Hollow Knight soul meter was probably something needlessly complicated, like
writing a shader, combining two or three sine waves, calculate which part of the sprite should be rendered, and then maybe add some noise texture to make the surface look less homogeneous.
Yeah, they used sprite frames and a mask so it would only be visible within the circle. We can basically just draw a few frames of animation that look close enough to a wave and use the fading circle from earlier as a mask. Then we can move the wave sprite up and down for different levels of fullness, soul, whatever. Anyhow, it gets us basically the same result as in the actual game. Now before we move on, I did want to add that little glow thingy the soul meter does when it's full. Usually, I would have done glow into D by using the actual glow settings with an HDR threshold, so only things with a brightness above the usual maximum of 1 actually glow. That is not working in the current version of Godot 4. So instead, I used a copy of the soul sprite and added an animation that scales it up and down a little. Close enough. Now for geo. So besides the icon, we need a label for your current number of geo, as well as a second one just for the temporary geo display when you just picked something up. Now in the actual game logic, we probably want a singleton or the player script to keep track of geo, adding and subtracting it instantly. At the same time, we can have the UI keep track of its own variables for geo and recently picked up geo. This allows us to keep game logic simple and easy to work with, while also having this nice juicy count up whenever you've collected geo for a while. In code, I opted to just tween the geo from the last known value to the actual current geo in game logic whenever nothing has been picked up for a while. Now the heads-up display is starting to come together, but it's still missing something important. Masks in Hollow Knight serve as your counter of hit points. Sounds simple enough, but they actually do a whole bunch of things. They have little animations when they first show up, or when you take damage, or when they just do this little shine thing sometimes. They also emit particles when you heal or are down to 1 health. And there are even blue ones for lifeblood, and honey ones with the hive blood charm, and all with their own set of animations. Alright, so we won't replicate all of that, but we can do enough to show how it works. So, let's put masks in a scene to keep them organized. Add an animation scaling them up when they first spawn. Use a single background frame in an animation for empty masks. Do the same for full masks. Add a little shine animation we can trigger from the UI parent, so all masks are synchronized when running it. Add particle systems for healing. One up, one down. Add another particle system for when you're on your last hit point. That one also needs a glow background. I could make another smoother one now, but I think you get the point. So I'll just use the soul circle instead and give it some transparency. Now with all those features, we do have to be a bit careful about how to trigger them. Some animations, like losing health, have to play immediately, cancelling whatever animation was playing before. Other animations can be queued, like transitioning from the spawn animation to the standard mask one. And if a broken case is rare enough, don't worry about it. Even Team Cherry didn't always get it right. We'll keep it at this. And in future, there are still some aspects of Hollow Knight, as well as several other games, I want to make similar videos on. If there's a specific feature from a game or something like that you would like to see a video on, let me know in the comments and I'll take a look and see what I can do. But for now, this will be all for today. Bye.